Hi Bucks, welcome back to my YouTube channel, and this is gonna be my first Sims video, which I'm really excited about because I fucking love The Sims. I haven't played The Sims in so long, so please don't roast me about the way that I'm playing, and I'm also playing on a old ass Mac. So, yeah, if it looks bad, if you are being judgmental, please stop. Next, hopefully, we can manifest a really nice gaming PC. But today, I'm gonna be using The Sims to manifest a real life apartment for myself, and hopefully, one day, we can see this video be transformed into a physical reality. That sounds insane, but you never know. You never know. We'll have the proof if it does happen one day, Bugs. But yeah, let's get started. So, since I am starting school soon and it's all online, I really want to have a space where it's relaxing and more bright so that I can, I don't know, be comfy. And I feel like I don't do as well in areas that are like super cluttered. It's hard for me to focus, and my space right now is so cluttered. Like, I hate having all of my stuff in one room, you know what I mean? Want to have my own space that feels entirely like everything is mine, and I can have my stuff in more areas of the apartment. So, yeah, I'm doing this build on the 1010 Alto Apartments from City Living. I really like it, and like halfway through this build, I realized that this apartment is way too big for it to just be me, which is what I was planning to move in real life. I was planning to move to a single one bedroom apartment, not super big. But I realized halfway through this build that it's kind of like way too big for me to just be the only person living there. So I will add a roommate. You'll see me add another room and another bathroom too, but I'll add another sim to this Let's Play that I'll begin in a couple videos, which I'm so excited for. But yeah, this apartment is ginormous. I didn't realize how big it was, but I mean, I get it. When you have a bunch of activities and you only have one single floor to do it, it'll probably be more challenging when I get further into the build instead of just having like the counters and stuff. I actually didn't even touch on this, but I really like building in The Sims, but I feel like I might do it a different way than a lot of people. I like building the skeleton and like having a general idea of everything that I'm doing. And then after figuring out the general layout and like figuring out the wall color, the floor color, the different countertops, that's when I go in and change the like actual decor and stuff like that. Like, I know certain things that I want. Like, I knew that I wanted that marble table to hold my TV, and I knew that I wanted a beige aesthetic and like a more clean and bare aesthetic with pops of pink and purples and other colors, if I so choose. Most of the time, I just want beige and like a little bit of pink. I don't know. That's like my preferred style when it comes to like rooms and decor. You'll see, especially in the living room, for areas where I spend more of my time and I'm not necessarily needing to focus that much, I do like the cozy and more cluttered aesthetic, like just to give that lived-in feeling in those areas. But when it comes to my room, I really prefer something. I really want something that is nice and pretty and comfy, and something that breeds inspiration and creativity and puts me at a base level of myself without adding anything else so that I can create what I need to, if that makes sense. I'm really hoping one of you understands what I'm trying to say here because I'm feeling kind of crazy, but I find clutter makes it really hard for me to focus. So I really can't wait to have this apartment. Right now, I'm just trying to add that extra room for the second roommate because I'm realizing at this point that I really have way too much space for myself. So I'm just moving the laundry room into this, what was going to be the bathroom and the kitchen, which I mean, I had too many bathrooms anyway. I feel like there doesn't need to be a kitchen, please. Anyways, yeah, so I'm just moving the laundry room and adding another room, and this laundry room is gonna be cute. Like the laundry room, I already know, and my apartment is going to be cluttered. I know it's probably gonna be the messiest part of my apartment, and I am perfectly okay with that. I think it's completely accurate. I've never been inside someone's laundry room that looked perfect and clean unless they're psychopaths. So I will be manifesting a cluttered laundry room. This general area right here is just gonna be the main part of my apartment for sure. It's gonna have the most stuff in it. The kitchen is another big part, which I'll finish next video. I got like the countertops finished, but yeah, I'll be spending a lot more time in the kitchen and in the living room because I want to save my room specifically for doing schoolwork, you know, making or editing YouTube videos and writing, and then of course sleeping. I really don't want my entire life to be in my room. I don't. Because I feel like that's the way that everything gets cluttered. So, yeah. I haven't decided if I want my Sim to be a witch or a vampire yet. I feel like since I'm starting this by manifesting, and that's the whole point of doing this build specifically, and then like little rituals, having crystals around the house, which I will definitely add when we start decorating this apartment, but like that aesthetic just fits so well with the witch, and I'll be, you know, studying and going to school, which is like, you know, that's like Harry Potter or whatever. I don't know, but I love vampires in The Sims, my favorite type of sim to play, and my favorite sim of all time was a vampire. She died, but you know, rest in peace. You know, it was so much fun. I had her for literal years, and you know, all of her family would die, and then I would just like get a new family. Okay, anyways, it's not important. Maybe one day we'll do something like that. It's like a fucked up version of generations because you have like everyone passing away, and your vampire just keeps like, all right, that was a nice family. All right, who are we gonna find this time around? Who are we gonna fall in love with? You know, what kind of job are we gonna take on? You like are able to change your entire identity as the years go on. It was really fun, and I had her completely maxed out too, which was another cool thing because I've never really maxed out every single skill in The Sims before for one single sim, and I did with her. I don't even remember how she actually ended up dying, but like I went through crazy stuff with her. I really did. I may have someone else make my roommate's room and my roommate's bathroom, and you know, maybe add some other touches to the apartment so that it looks like someone else lives there. which I think is cool. Instead of me making everything, I don't know. But I might have someone else help with that. I'm not sure if I'll get that recorded or not for y'all, but we'll see. Hopefully next video I will have this build completely finished, and then we can move on to creating our sims, which I also have a lot of fun doing. I especially hope that my room in real life looks like the room in this apartment. I really, really like the way that it turned out. It looks really relaxing, and obviously I'll have more stuff, like add some candles, add, I don't know, really the candles, that's what I want, because, you know, it already looks pretty, and I just want it to smell good, and I'll be happy. But yeah, the candles, the room looks nice, the bathroom looks nice. I don't think it's quite done, and I think I get a little irritated with the bathroom because it's not coming out exactly how I want my actual apartment to look. It's not coming out the way that I want my apartment to be manifested, you know what I mean? But yeah, we're gonna see. Until next time, I hope you all have amazing days, amazing moments in your life. Y'all are finding happiness and peace within yourself. I know it's a crazy time right now, so I hope you're taking enough time to not be working too hard and stressing yourself out, and you're taking enough time to really care for yourself, take a bath, take a longer shower, eat good, work out a little, do a little yoga, and play some fucking games. Okay, I won't cuss. Play some games. Yeah, and until next time, bugs. I hope you enjoyed my little unfinished build. You know, big manifestations like this take a lot of time, and I'm not one to rush my... I'm not one to rush at all. So I will definitely hit y'all with another video finishing this up completely. Hopefully. We'll see.